Hey, all deserves. Welcome back to XCOM and this freaking Terra mission, man. What an absolute nightmare this has become. Absolute nightmare. But it looks like we finally managed to save some civilians, which is huge. And the Stims are helping Saint run in and out, duck and weave, do the damage, do the business, and get the hell out again. So we're just going to go toe-to-toe with a mechtoid. Hope you don't mind. 4DR, even the breaching ammo, because, you know, screw you, I guess, is what the game is saying right now. But luckily, Hank's going to be able to do most of this work. It's looking at still got 17 hit points. It's quite a bit. Hank's got 100% chance to hit the damn thing. 9 damage, eh? Yeah, that may not do it. I do have heat grenades on my mech, though, which I'm going to probably employ here. Grenades mainly get the damage out and deal with the sectoid's cover in the interim. So I'm going to start working on this a little bit. All right. Oh, there's the Muton. Hi. Just when I thought he was done for. We could do it like this. Do most of the damage to the mechtoid and also clear the sectoid's cover. Just a little bit like that would be nice and handy right now. Alright, that took 9 damage there. I actually creamed the sectoid. Alright, that's fine by me. Saint already took his shot, so he's going to have to get pulled out. I'm just doing this for vision in case I do another derp like I did last time. And that should be a kill, so let's get Hank that one. Hank is just a freaking executioner these days, I gotta say. He's doing remarkably good work for me. And who else does Hank see? I hope it's the Muton, actually. We can get that problem dealt with. No, it's that sectoid. Can we move and get that Muton? Probably not, because that armored car is actually doing a hell of a job blocking him from anything I want to do. I might get this angle down here, though, actually. Hold on. Go right there. That's what I'm looking at. That's what I wanted to see. Another ITZ. ITZ is strong. ITZ strong. Reload that gun. Hank, you've done good work already. Thank you for your contribution. So what do we have active now currently? 2 floaters and 2 sectoids. I mean, there's definitely some civvies out there I'd love to save, but Saint's going to have to do some bit more running to deal with these floaters that are going to be running around us in a second. All right. Now, Sugar... Well, that floater comes through that door. I'm going to be pretty screwed. I'll probably want to put Sugar actually on this side in case he does. Now we took care of the Muton. That's probably the safest place for her because I want him to come through that door and bone me. Krungle is going to probably take this position with Overwatch in case that floater comes through there and decides to build a structurally superfluous new asshole in our medic, which I'm not a fan of in general. Or, you know, in principle, I don't like that, basically, is what I'm trying to say. I'm going to get Mammy. That floater can flank him pretty easy down this pipe. Let me get Mammy here. Look, there's some civvies cowering over there, which I may try to save. Let me reload. Let me see what the motion track is telling me about. Okay, we got a pack also still straight up in here, right back there. Probably another. No, we heard 2 stompy mechs already. So let me just reload the gun, and we'll decide what the hell to do after that. I don't know, man. This has been a rough one. It's been a rough one. Don't know what to say besides that. But it really does seem like every single Terra mission is a rough one at this rate. Okay, so they're jetting over that way. Okay, that's an easy kill for Saint. And they actually didn't kill any civvies, so I'm actually alright with this state of affairs. Alright, Maximus. And we're going to have to take a peek at where the other floater went. This may be running right into an Overwatch, but I'm actually okay with that. So, Saint, come around here. Is that the safest way to go, I guess? I guess it kind of is. And get rid of that floater for me, because he's not floating right now. Oh, you're going up on the roof to do that. That's fascinating. Okay, we got 1 shot down here. The other floater's obviously flying high right now. But this is an easy flank kill, so let's take the hit and run. 11 crit. Yeah. You're on reserves. I know. They're ending. Your reserves are ending, basically, is what he's saying. Alright, 2 sectors and a floater and another enemy pack up there. What I'm going to do then, if the enemy pack is there, I'm going to go and try and save these civilians, my mech. It's probably the best thing I can do right now, is get out here. And like I said, the enemy seems to be in that direction. We can probably take a peek at what that is. Mammy, give us some intel. Like, what are we looking at? We are looking at... That's where it was, I think. The enemy pack.
Surveillance de la zone.
What do we got? Yeah, it's more lids. Oh, interesting, we have another pack of lids. I know, it's one lid and it looks like a boss heavy floater. Are you shitting me right now? Really? Yep, that looks like a boss heavy floater to me. Boss not as in like awesome, but like he's a boss monster, dude. Okay, that's not cool. That's really not cool. But at least we have a heat-equipped sniper to hit the roof. Though I don't think they count as mechanical, but either way, sniper on the roof.
Running.
It's always a win in my book, so... Oh wait, crap, the floater's up there, isn't it? Oh, and sometimes I derp out hard, and this was one of those times. Okay, so it's not gonna be Operation Save Hank because we're about to get murdered. Can we get someone up on the roof that's not gonna get themselves killed? Nope, Krungle pretty much has no way to do that. So looks like Hank's gonna take some floater love, and I totally forgot about that guy thinking about setting up for the heavy floaters already. I'm getting ahead of myself and I'm dying because of it. That's not good. Before I was just dying from bad luck, now I'm dying from being dumb. Alright, Saint can't really do much except maybe give this floater another target. Hey, do you want to take shot at this tough looking assault guy and not Hank? Because if he's in visual range, Saint's gonna want to take the plasma. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, shoot Saint, he'll be fine. Saint, sorry. If you're watching this, sorry, man. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. In this case, it's put you out there to take another plasma shot, which I tend to do a lot these days, I gotta say. I feel bad about that. Sort of, though. Because you are an assault and you are a badass, so I can kinda justify that. To myself, at least, if not the viewers here. Alright, now, anyway, I'm gonna go out here with the mech and try to save these folk.
En route to target.
We know where the last pack is, so we're not gonna trigger them by going around here. We may trigger them through that doorway. Which is a little, I don't know, I'm not too happy about that part, but not much I can do. You overwatch in case he runs across the roof for some ass backwards reason, or back asswards reason. Either way, it's a bad reason.
Good copy.
Go up that way, further away from that, and yeah, I don't know. We'll see what's going to happen in a couple seconds with Hank. I really hope he's not the one to get shot, but I'm not holding out hope. It's very likely he's going to be the target. Oh, that fell down, so I have an easier time of seeing the floaters that are going to try to murder me in my sleep. That's great. Don't kill the civvy. Now you're getting a little bit of extra oomph, aren't you? That's fine. Just don't kill the civvy. Then I'll be happier. Wow, you can move far. Yeah, you didn't patrol much there, huh, buddy? Well, like I meant... Oh, no, I probably am going to see them through there. He's going to get up close and Saint. Yeah, he's going to shoot Saint. The hell? Okay, I'll take that one as a win. I am not going to look a gift horse in the mouth, or anywhere else for that matter. I don't know, gift horses, they're strange animals. I don't like watching them. Alright, let's go save these people. Two more. If I activate the heavy floaters, so be it. And I did not activate the heavy floaters. Two more civilians alive, which is already a huge boon. And let's see if we can grenade this little douchebag over here. I don't think I can, actually. Got the wrong angle for it, but that's alright. Mech being out here in surprise mode is probably the best thing I've got going for me right now. What do you have? 76 here. You have 100% chance to maybe execute one of these bastards. That's not bad. I am going to need to deal with that floater in some big way, though. Huh. Alright. Well, let's... Is there any other way to deal with this floater besides Hank and Saint? I think Saint is probably the... best thing I've got going for me. Come on. Alright. Well, Hank's gonna have to deal with his own problem here at this point. Hank's gonna have to run up with his pistol, which I'm glad I equipped him with, and handle the floater. But that's alright. Hank's made to do some dynamo stuff, as we saw already. Get yourself right there and handle that floater. If those guys are just sitting there not killing civilians, I'm kind of content to let them do that. Hey. 7 crit. Man, Hank almost did as much damage as Saint did with his shotgun. I think he's trying to say something, Saint. You should be offended. Alright, one for all. And overwatch the corner in case sectoids come around it. I don't want to trigger these guys if I don't need to. I may, though, if I try to rush out this way. Because that may peak right there. So I'm actually not going to do that. Overwatch the heater in case they decide to get active, but... beyond that, I'm going to kind of sit back, get my guns reloaded, and then go in for the last final haul here. Set that up. Krung will get on this doorway, because they're probably going to rush out this way at some point, and reload the gun. All right, and then Maximus, now that we're done healing up our engineer, who needed desperate amounts of healing, get yourself right there to support everyone up in the front line.
Orders confirmed.
Go there, buddy. Behind this armored car. Sectoids are still rushing around. They don't know my mech is here, which is good. Might be able to get an easy kill on these guys. They're unawares. Yeah, I might be able to get a nice grenade shot. What I may try to do is activate these guys with Hank. Provided I had vision, but I do not. Well, Mammy, guess what you're doing, buddy? Battle Scanner Anku. Right about... No. I need you to go over here. Need vision of these guys. So Hank can set up his dynamo shot. Okay, we good? Yeah, we good. Alright, Hanky Poo. Where are you? Yeah, we need to get you back on that corner, bro. That was a really good position for you. Especially on the high ground. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. What do you got? You got me that one, and you got me that one. That's the big daddy. He's probably going to heal up pretty good. I'm trying to question the wisdom of dropping a grenade on him first. Sank's at high ground right now. I wonder if it'll make sense. Can I throw a grenade through here into those guys? Probably asking for too much. Yeah, not quite right, my positioning is.
Strange talking, I do.
I could start secretly scooting my mech around this way. This is a blue move, seriously? God damn. Color me surprised. But I'm able to probably save two more civvies because of that, so you know what? I'm gonna make that blue move in a second. Let me get Hank to activate this, and then we'll see what happens next. I don't much envy what's about to happen, but you know. 100% the big guy is 100% the big guy, and I'm gonna take that crit chance while I've got it. What's up, bro? 11 crit. Yeah, it's not bad. Could be a lot more damage, but they're not mechanical, so I guess you can only ask for so much. These guys really spread the hell out when I activated them. So Mammy could be in a bit of a bad way. I'm gonna drop a smoke back here while I can. And my mech is not awesome right now because of the heavy floater inside the building, but I can probably still do good work on this. Let's see if we can save. Save some civvies. Two? Just one. The other guy's still in there. Trying to get a nice overlap position where I can save as many civilians as I can. That sector doesn't know I'm here. Neither does that floater. So this might be a good time to get some damage in. I don't mind a lid rushing up on me because that's pretty simple. If I can be like the bastion, the bulwark against these civvies, and take care of some nasty shit in the background here in the process. That would not be a bad idea, actually. Let's get a grenade going right about there. Probably kill the sectoid and do some good work on that heavy floater as well. No one even know I'm here, honestly. I mean, they will now. Oh, really? One damage away from the sectoid? That's kind of poopy.
Contacts are attempting to retreat.
They better be attempting to retreat. They just got their asses handed to them a little. Yeah, Lid is not going to have ability to run up on Morris right now, so I'm gonna probably try to... Can you psychic a lid? You can, but their will is remarkably good. Color me surprised, actually. I am very, very surprised. Surprised at a color, I would be it. There is a civvy right there, which is pretty much done for at this point. Krungle... I think the overwatch from high ground may be the best thing you've got going for you all day. Let me get you up there. Probably the few chances Krungle's gonna have to make a really long move up to the top of something. It'll be okay. The mech could be in a little bit of a rough position right now. Because, well, reasons, obviously. Heavy floater with anger is bad for a mech's health and sanity. But it doesn't seem to have any... Yeah, none of the enemies have vision on Yassine right now, which is pretty cool. They just don't know where the grenade came from. Seem to be taking advantage of a good position. I'm gonna keep doing that. So I'm gonna get Saint down here. So he's kind of the whipping boy a little bit with that massive armor. And reload his alloy cannon. So we can do some good work. Sugar, I think, needs to stay back. I may put her even further. Nah, screw it. I'm going to put her further back. This is bull. I'm going to get Moxie was further back. So let me get a smoke up in case Mammy decides to bite it. Go right there, because that guy, if he rushes up on Mammy, he's going to have a really easy shot of it. There we go. And let me get right about there, just in case I get grenaded. I don't want too much grenade bait here. 78. That really improves my wheel, I gotta say. I would like some more damage, though, so give me some of that, please. Nice. 9 in the hollow. Pretty good. Sugar can stay in the pit here a little bit. I may honestly put her right there. I don't know. I want a good position to Vertusk grenades from, and I gotta keep kind of stay relevant for that to happen. Let me sit here and hunker in case something does come in over the pipe. We'll decide. Sector's like, where the hell did that grenade come from? I am not a happy camper right now. They had to know I'm back there. That Sector saw me run by. But I guess they're just going to intend to sit there and act like idiots. All right. As long as they don't run around and kill civvies, I'm okay. Holy crap! I didn't have vision on that guy. I didn't think he actually saw me. I wouldn't have stayed there had I known that. Minimal damage is not 16. That's a guy with heat ammo. All right, that is officially not healthy for my mech. Oh, and it's wiping out civvies just from my vision range. Okay, that was not funny. That was really quite not funny. These civvies are done for, and if I want my mech to live, I gotta pull her out right now. Unfortunately. Dude, that is a certified badass right there. Holy crap. Okay, like I said, I probably would not have sat there had I known he actually had vision on me. Unfortunately, I did not know that. I have 100% in a couple, so this is going to be good. Let me get hollow up on the floating dude. And Hank might be able to execute this guy in a good way here. Nice, okay, so that'll be an easy execution for Hank, I'm hoping. Let me run the double tap, though. I mean, who needs it if I can kill him right now? Yeah, got him, good. Only shot we had in Morse. Now I'm really, really, really worried about my mech. God damn. Saint, you got to do something about that, bro. Where are you guys? You got eyes on that guy, right? 18%. Are you serious right now? All right, you got to do better than that, Saint. I may have to put him in a really nasty spot, but these guys did not cheat up on us at all, so Kringle's position is pretty much freaking worthless for me. So go right there, I guess. I got to get my mechy mech out of there. To a way that guy's not going to see the mech, but he's floating, so he's going to have a pretty good eye on almost everything. Shit, I want to save the civvy, but at this rate, this is not worth it for the amount of damage I'm going to take. I'm going to need to probably put my mech all the way out here. It's a blue move here. I get blue move to save the civvy, and then I can yellow move out this way, I think, and that's going to be good, yeah. Let me blue move here to save the civvy. Position confirmed. Yeah, heat ammo's no joke, guys. Oh, are you serious? I already saved that one. God damn it. Alright, apparently that's just a fake civilian. Cool, I guess. Why don't we go here and pretend that floater doesn't see us? Because that was a lot of freaking damage. Okay, now Mammy's gonna have to go do some work for me. I'm not gonna have in the zone on anything here, unfortunately. Well, let's see. I might be able to get a flank on that sectoid, actually, if I have the angle. That building's kind of messed up at this point. And if I have 86 on that guy, and I'm 100% on that guy. I'll probably still get good aim if I put Hank on the corner here. I might be able to get flanks on those sectoids. Yeah, I got a flank on one of them at least. Yeah, it's 100% flank right there. Give me that. Make it easier for Saint to run up on. Nice. And we can try and get another gunshot down. 94. Oh, it's less good than it was, but it can still do serious work, so let's do that. He's content to sit on the ground. Sugar might be able to just go and drop a grenade on him. Yeah, I think that may be what I need to do. Unfortunately, how far do you got? You can pretty much just get here and do it, I think.
Okay.
Really? Not quite, eh? That's just the wrong angle every time, every direction. All right, stay right there then. We'll get him set up for that, and we'll probably bait him in with Mammy. Basically make him think Mammy's the threat, and then just revealed check with our engineer. You have no vision on anything, really? All right, so we'll heat her overwatch for now. Now, I want to make sure that this guy considers Saint the big threat. And Saint can't be crit, so going toe-to-toe with that is probably what he's made for. So let's go here and see, to make sure that guy knows that we're after his ass. And he leaves my mech the hell alone. Missing a 71 does not help, though, Saint, honestly. Does not help the situation. Alright, let me get this up here. And set up an Overwatch, I guess. The best I'm gonna be able to do right now. Yeah, I needed that shot to connect, but it's not really happening. You're gonna rush out that way because you don't want to mess with Saint in close quarters, apparently. Mammy's got that Overwatch, damn. Well, I'm glad I put the heater out on him. That was a chance to actually connect that guy. Hardy. Yeah, that's what I wanted. I mean, I didn't want the damage, but the adrenaline surge and the nine damage is not fatal. Son of a bitch. The lid back there is going to get the last remaining civilian turned into a zombie. Yeah, there we go. Alright. Well, and this dude is still floating like nobody's business. He's going to float on alright. Okay, so what do we have eyes on? 100%, 86%, and that guy, the big danger, is still floating there like an asshole. Alright, reload the gun, Hank, and then we're going to probably have to do what we can from this point onward. Sugar, where you at? There we go. Get Sugar right on this corner. Probably be able to get that grenade right on target. I mean, do we want to waste the grenade here if Hank can execute this thing? Well, Hank can maybe get rid of that sectoid, which will give Saint that much more breathing room, I guess. So let's get this easy kill down first. But that big dude is no joke. Okay, it's not an easy kill. It's actually a very unhappy floater right now. That's why that guy's so easy to hit. He's actually not covered. That's fascinating. All right. That's why he's so easy to hit. Bye. Cool. And you can also unload on that sectoid if you would be so kind. Nice. Alright, Hank's been doing some ridiculous work on this mission, I gotta say. That dude is borderline the MVP of this. Borderline, I say, because everyone's pitching in like crazy. So Saint's got the combat cocaine rolling. He could probably go toe-to-toe with this guy. But leaving him alone, taking 9 more, would put him still in a decent okay position. And then we're gonna have to really support Saint up if we're gonna try to get this one down. Krungle, how, like, just, really, the movement is really murdering me right now. And I have just nothing doing on this. I have nothing doing on this floater. Alright. Maximus. And get yourself up here. We're gonna have to start closing the noose a little.
Solid copy, Commander.
Because that dude is scary. Oh, now we have vision with that guy. That's peachy keen. Let's get you... Oh, wow, you have no movement either. That's the story of this mission. That's what I was afraid of taking the squad. My movement is not going to be stellar. And Morris, come up here. I got to start supporting Saint a little bit. If he has more targets, he may back off a little bit. All right, Saint. Now, do we put you out there? Or do we put you in cover and take another shot? Problem is not hit and run. The 66, that's not a lot of good aim. Yassine took it really on the chin with this guy. The heat ammo is just absolutely brutalizing me. So we gotta bring this back a little bit. We see the lid, but again, that's not within range of enclosed. War Master, indeed. Another one of these bastards. And that's a pretty good name for these things. These things are scary as hell. Oh, nice shot, Saint. He took the 30% and ran with it. Alright, that's good. And the danger here is, yeah, like I said, I can't actually expose my mech, which is a weird position to be in. But I can't actually expose my mech for fear of horrible death. And I think it's all the civvies, yeah. So we saved 5. That's not too bad. Alright, how are we gonna make this guy expose himself a little bit more? Could take Mammy through this corner and freak him out by that way. No, not really, but I'm gonna heat her overwatch. In case that lid decides to come knocking. And where do I bring my mech that's not gonna get me killed by that heavy floater? So I gotta basically rush her all the way around to where our arc thrower is, which is way the hell over there. So my mech, unfortunately, not gonna be able to do too much for me right now. I kind of keep her there, I guess, in armor, and he's probably gonna still focus on Saint, but probably be safest to bring my mech back here and drop the armor on. So she'll probably survive another shot. If we really need to go balls in, we'll just go and knock him down. Alright, that's the best I've got. So zombie's gonna come up, but the lid is now really confused. It's got nothing to eat. The hell? Maximus is down. Are you freaking kidding me right now? One-shotted through cover? Wow. Gotta be freaking kidding me. And I didn't trigger CQC for some reason there. Unbelievable. Un-be-freaking-leavable. The luck of this mission is just not with us, man. Ah. That's so sad. Maximus went down. He's such a solid operator. Shoot. And now I need to start rebuilding my medic corps. I'm pretty much out of senior medics. And that is just god-awful. Oh, alright. And now I'm still having serious trouble with this freaking heavy floater. 56%. I mean, my god. Ugh. Man, can you please do some work on this guy? This is really starting to piss me off. Open the door. And shoot that motherfucker, please. I did drop the F-bomb there for a reason. This guy's ridiculous. Alright, I may have to drop all my freaking power to knock this guy down right now. 11 crit. Can't believe Maximus went down. Oh, I'm so sad. So sad. He's turning into one hell of a medic, too. Damn it. Damn it. Yeah, I'm really salty right now, man. Man. Do that to support Saint. I got him crit through cover. Like, really. That's not funny. Saint, can you handle that on your own? So I don't have to bring more ammunition to bear if I don't need to. No, I may have to, actually, this rate. Holy crap, that thing is tough. Yep, that thing is tough. It is still up at one hit point. But that is the last thing that's on this map, right? Yeah, Chrysalid and a zombie.
Got it covered.
What a day. What a day in China. Not only are we losing the continent, we're lost to Samir. For the bargain. Ugh. Alright, that's really sad. Alrighty. Let's clean this up and go home. Though again, losing a senior operative like Samir is just...
by the numbers.
It's not funny. Not funny at all. That's very, very, very sad, and we're gonna have trouble rebuilding from that. Because we've lost both Samir and we've lost... Jolie last time on the base defense, and Sugar's gravely wounded because of that bullshit 11 crit through cover. Man, I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. That was an awful mission for us. Got a Zerker captive, but that's small consolation for what we lost, man. That was horrible. Yeah, and all that's broken for obvious reasons, because screw you. Let's go and repair everything, because really no more choice there. And obviously we know we're losing China this month. Yeah, there's nothing we can do about that. So the first satellite we're going to launch is to try to recover China. Unfortunately, that's also going to be a problem because we're about to lose one in South America. I can't do anything about that.
We've lost some of our satellite coverage.
And there we go. And we also lost a satellite.
Any UFO contacts in that area.
And we need to get on this abduction like yesterday. So, yeah. This has been a rough one. But I'll see you all next time. We'll persevere. We'll survive. I've been Nurses in Mexicom, and I'll see you next time. Till then.